Welcome to the Horror Hotel. Let's talk about violence and censorship in the movies. While we see a lot of the former and a lot less of the latter, there are some interesting points to take up about them both. When it comes to violence in particular, and especially in horror, as it tends to be blood and gore, it has sparked controversy before and actually caused a lot of the moral panic we saw during the 70s and 80s. When it comes to movies, violence and sex seems to spark the most controversies overall, and as they do, the censorship debates once again blossom. So, let's talk a little bit about it, shall we? And ignore my cat. I have researched around a little bit to try to find the first movie that was ever censored, and I might be wrong on this one, so correct me if I am, but it seems to be Anders Ulf the Andern in 1920 for containing homosexual themes. By this time, movies was a new media type and wasn't very violent, but as I mentioned in the intro, it's both violence and sexual hints or contents that have been especially targeted throughout the years. In most of the cases in early filmmaking, the movies were not cut, but outright banned, and some of them even destroyed. In Nazi Germany, for example, the movie Anders Ulf the Andern was almost wiped from the face of the earth by the Nazis in 1933, 13 years after its official release. And while you might think that only fascist regimes or theocracies are banning movies, you would be dead wrong. The United Kingdom actually banned The Exorcist from being distributed to home video for a decade due to its very graphic nature. Lines like "Your mother sucks cocks in hell" and a scene kinda graphically showing the demon girl masturbating with a crucifix wasn't particularly popular with the finer English folks, and they did not want this shock horror to the public in form of home video. Yeah, it's almost like the conservatives are a little bit political correct and offended. There is a lot of other famous examples of banned or cut movies that government have banned for their shocking graphical nature, be it extreme nudity or sex scene or violence so shocking at the time that they felt the need to protect the public. And it's kind of interesting if you view this and compare it to today's outrage culture from people holding conservative viewpoints and want to back to a less degenerate period of time screams about censorship, when they themselves absolutely think that art should be censored. Usually, when depicting violence in movies, they usually go for an unrealistic aesthetic. In action movies, the heroes and villains usually can't die in a fistfight, as they are superhuman with both the pain threshold and skeleton built as a Terminator. And in horror movies, the violence is either off-screen so you can't see it, or it is also pretty ridiculous with its gore or methods used to kill, etc. I don't think anyone has seen Friday the 13th or a Nightmare on Elm Street movies and think, yeah, that can happen. But there are other examples of much more realistic violence that gets the same ratings, such as I Spit on Your Grave or an incident in Ghostland. The difference in these kind of depictions of violence is big, because an incident in Ghostland and the director's other movie, Martyrs, really does not fall under the ridiculous radar as much as nerve-wracking and horrifying, which in and of itself, you know, it's good, but it's still very different, yet it is rated exactly the same by the censorship agencies in various countries. All countries do have different rating systems, and some of them are worse than others. Germany are pretty strict when it comes to it, but a big outlier in the so-called Western world would definitely be Australia. For example, the movie Irreversible was initially banned after its first tour in Australia due to Michael Atkins of the Australian Rating Board, as he claimed the director and studio lied to him when they submitted it for ratings. And he claimed they said that it contained no sexual or violent scenes. He stated, and I quote, "I would happy for them to resubmit it. There might be some fault with the form. It's certified that the film contained no explicit sexual or violent scenes, but I read the plot notes and that was not true." Which kind of brings me a little bit to my point about the rating system and how censorship in general seems to be a little bit on the fly. Personally, I think the rating system instead should be focused on tags or trigger warnings. if you will, rather than age to determine if you can see them. And before you can accuse me of wanting 7-year-olds having nightmares, hear me out. If we have one rating for family and kids friendly and the rest like PG-15 instead, and we instead focus on the actual content of the film so the people knew what they were up for, I think it would be beneficial for both the viewers and the studios. Now, I'm not saying that it would be a superior idea, but I would also argue that movies like Martyrs and Ghostland, rather than age restriction / rating, would be better off with either trigger warnings or tags, because I can tell you right now that those movies contain something that does not stop shocking people because they are turning 18. Or anything, as the realism of the violence might be really bad for some people. And I think it would be easier for them to not accidentally step into these movies through some sort of tag system rather than age. Because while I for one can handle it, I was not prepared for what I got. And there is a lot of movies that would fare better this way as well, like Irreversible or I Spit on Your Grave, and I think this might be a pretty interesting topic to discuss because the system right now is downright flawed and kind of broken. And it has this side effect that studios are actively censoring their own movies to reach a broader audience when they really shouldn't have to, because they wanted PG-13. But also, I would say, stop hating on PG-13, there is nothing wrong with movies rated that. Thank you all for watching this video, and I wonder what your take on this subject of censorship and ratings are. Leave a comment down below and tell me what you think about my views, and if I'm wrong, you can always tell me off, you know that already. There are interesting thoughts to be told on this topic. All the links for everything is down below, even some sources. And my personal links as well. You can find me on Twitter and on Curious Cat and even on Patreon, but I barely use Patreon. And well, and if you like more content, don't forget to subscribe. You can do it down below or at the end of this video where you can click my icon to subscribe and help me out. And also, you know, the algorithm seems to like likes. So if you like this video, it would get shown more, so I would get more views, which I don't know how it helps you, but, you know. So I'll see you guys next time.